Yeah. West Coast, what the fuck it is? It's your comrade, your big homie, Young Noble. Represent them legendary outlaws. Wanna send a shout out to the homie Boss Solo. Block Hustle Inc. You already know what it is, man. It's Outlaw for Life. Boss Solo, make it happen, my nigga.
Yo, what it do? This Boss Solo, CEO of Block Hustle Inc. Live on Hip Hop News 24/7 West with Young Noble of the Outlaws. What's cracking, Young Noble?
Everything lovely, man. Just getting to it, man. Staying blessed and focused, man.
Shit, that's what's up, man. So, how the industry life treating Young Noble?
Man, I don't know. I don't really live the industry life. I live a normal, regular life, man. Got an industry job, I guess.
Okay. I'm going to pop the first question off about Young Buck. Was Young Noble ever signed to Young Buck's label, Cashville Records? What's the situation on that, man? What's the business, bro?
We're not signed with Cashville. You know, Buck is the homie. You know what I mean? Like, you know, we was in process of signing, you know, before he went through a situation with 50. But, you know, the relationship we got with Buck is past music. Like, you know, when that whole shit popped off with him and 50, you know, a lot of people turned their back on him. You know what I mean? A lot of his close in the circle, you know, turned their back on him, thought it was over for him. But, you know, we riders, man. We some loyal dudes. So, you know, contract or no contract, you know, that's our brother and that's our soldier and that's our comrade. And we fuck with Buck. So, you know, our relationship with Buck is really way deeper than some rap, hip-hop shit. You know what I mean? Like, that's our young brother right there. So, you know, we fuck with Buck from that aspect. You know, we still tour together. We still do music together. And it's a movement. You know what I mean? Like, Cashville, period. Like, you know, when we started fucking with him, we was about to sign. You know, just his whole circle, like, you know, his whole city pretty much ride with us. You know what I mean? So, you know, his Cashville shit is bigger than, you know, it's bigger than the Outlaws, it's bigger than Buck, it's bigger than Sebo. It's really just a movement, man. It's just some young brothers, you know, pretty much riding with each other, man, getting to this money, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm glad we cleared that up for the record.
I want to know, man, you signed with a major label, or would you sign with a major label, man, if given a chance?
I mean, I would sign with a major label, definitely, if the situation was right, you know what I mean? But, you know, we just got a new situation. Our new album will come out through Fontana Universal. You know, this is probably, you know, the little situation we have. I ain't going to get too in detail with our business, but, you know, it's probably the best, you know, situation as far as money-wise and distribution-wise, you know, we had in years. You know what I mean? So, you know, this is a great situation for us, and we're going to take full advantage of it. You know what I mean? With this new album, it's perfect timing during our reunion album with the dog Hussein Fatal.
For those who can't attend and don't really know, like, what a Pac party's like, tell them what a Tupac birthday party's like.
Well, a Pac party is just a gangster party. I mean, honestly, you know, every time we do a concert, it's a Pac party. You know what I mean? So, you know, Pac birthday, you know, it's on June 16th, but, you know, we rep for the big homie. Every day, everything we do is in the name of Pac. You know what I mean? When I step outside of my house and, you know, five niggas might run down on me today, you know, it's pretty much, you know, the same response. You know what I mean? Like, you know, niggas love the history and love what we did. You know what I mean? Fucking with the big homie Pac. So, you know, every day we rep for the big homie. But, you know, definitely whenever we do a concert, it's pretty much an outlaw Pac party. You know what I mean? He definitely be in the building whenever we in the building, for sure.
Yeah, you feel the spirit, man. That's what's up, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I personally know from doing my history, we had some cat saying he started the One Nation. You know what I'm saying? Not starting no beef, not shouting no names out. Let the people know who started One Nation and what is One Nation, what is that all about?
Well, you know, Pac started One Nation, you know what I mean? You know, One Nation was something Pac created, you know, pretty much to counter what the media was doing. You know, when it came out with the Hit 'Em Up, you know, they made it, instead of it being about two individuals, which it was, you know, they made it pretty much about a whole coast, you know what I mean? East Coast, West Coast, doing black people, we pretty much the only people that they could do that to. Like, you know, they could print up something in a magazine and, you know, black folks, we'll read it and be so ignorant. It, you know, we'll just hold on to it. Next thing you know, you got all these people that don't know each other mad at each other for no reason. So that's what happened. You know, Pac, not only Pac, but all the outlaws are from the East Coast. So, you know, he didn't like how the media was portraying it. So, you know, he was ahead of his time. Damn near genius, like, you know what I mean? So he was like, you know what? We about to do this One Nation shit, and I'm about to fuck with all the East Coast niggas. All the niggas on the East Coast that even the big-time East Coast niggas ain't fucking with, we gonna fuck with them. You know what I mean? And he, you know, and before he died, we was in the process of doing a whole One Nation album. You know what I mean? We had the first dudes. You know, we was the young dudes tied to the streets. You know what I mean? So, you know, Pac was pretty much like, who we should fuck with first and foremost, you know what I mean? And we was like, you know, the boot camp, like them was niggas we was fucking with. So he had flew all the boot camp out there, Smith and Wesson, Buckshot. We had Greg Nice out there. He was pretty much gonna put, you know, half the East Coast was gonna be on this motherfucking CD, and the shit would have probably went triple to four times platinum if it was executed how it should have been executed. Not only was it was going to be East Coast dudes on there, but it was going to be, you know, South dudes on there, Midwest dudes on there, West Coast dudes on there. It was just something, you know, it was just something Pac was trying to get back to the game. Like, you know, he wasn't trying to make this shit like no East Coast, West Coast shit. Yeah, you know, he's nigga from the East Coast, you know what I mean? So that was just his way of countering the shit. Like, you know what? All right, well, we're going to counter this shit, and we're going to fuck with all the East Coast niggas that the big East Coast niggas ain't even fucking with. And that was just really some military-minded shit. But, you know, he was about to shake up the game with the One Nation shit. So, you know, that's something Pac started. It pretty much was just like, you know, One Nation is just real niggas getting money, man. You know what I mean? No matter where the fuck you from, you know what I mean? If you about getting your green, you know what I mean? We fucking with you. That's what it was about.
So all that East Coast, West Coast beef, that was all bullshit.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I mean, just dudes in the game. Like, you know how you got dudes.